Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about while loop. In our previous classes, we already discussed about conditional statements and indentation. So please watch that class and come back here because we use the concepts here in this class. Please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete Python language. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, we will understand while loop by taking a simple example. But in our next classes, in our coming classes, we will do many of the practical complex problems using these loops and conditional statements. Here we will take very simple examples for understanding how while loop executes. Coming to our today's class, let's take an example. Suppose if someone asked you to display the numbers from 1 to 5. Up to the knowledge which we gained in our previous classes, what we do for displaying the numbers from 1 to 5. So we'll write the code like this: print 1, print 2, third one, fourth one, fifth one. If someone asked you to display the numbers from 1 to 100, so how many times we have to write this code? We have to write this code for 100 times. Is it the best practice to do? No, it is not the best practice. In these situations, we are using the same code. Print statement, we are using multiple times with change in input value. Here we are changing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that, with change in values, we are using the same code. We are using the same block of code, print statements. So here comes the use of loop. Whenever we are having a block of code that is repeated for different values for many times, at that situations, we can use the loop statements. One of the loop statement is while loop. We are having two types of loops in Python. One is while loop and the second one is a for loop, which we discuss in our next class. So the loop should be repeated until some condition is met. So what's the condition in this situation? What's the condition? We have to stop at 5. If someone asked you to display the numbers up to 100, how many times you write this printf statement? 100 times. So here the condition is 100. After 100, don't go beyond that. Like that, we have to stop the loop based on the condition. So let's check the while loop condition, how we can write this code in a simple while loop. Let's take I is equal to 1, while, check the condition the same way, if conditions, if some condition is satisfied, then execute the if block of code. Like that same way, while I less than or equal to 5, if this condition satisfies, means if this condition, this is comparison operator, if it returns true, then execute this block of code. This block of code belongs to while loop. So that's why we have given indentation here. Here, this block of code belongs to while loop. If this condition satisfies, execute this code. Again, check the condition. If condition satisfies, execute the code. Again, check the condition, like that, until the condition fails. The loop will execute until the condition fails. Let's check how it will execute it. Y is equal to 1, 1 less than or equal to 5. Yes, the condition is true. So go inside and execute the block of code. Print I means, what's the output we'll get? 1. I is equal to I plus 1. I plus 1 means 2. Again, check the condition. 2 less than or equal to 5. So if it went inside and execute this block of code for one time, we call this as a one iteration. Coming to second iteration, it is checking the condition again, 2 less than or equal to 5. Yes, condition satisfied. Again, execute this block of code. What is this? Second iteration. We are in the second iteration. Print 2, I value is 2. Again, increment the I value. Now, again, check the condition. Third iteration, fourth iteration, fifth iteration. When I is equal to 6, the condition fails, so it will come out of the loop and it will continue executing the remaining program. So that's why these two are at the same level. So indentation, I hope you already watched our previous indentation class. You understand that after coming out of this, when the condition fails, it will continue executing the remaining program. So what's the output we'll get it from this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. After that, thank you. this is the output we get from this program. If you want to repeat it for 100 times, no need to write like this 100 times. Just change the value with 5, replace with 100. It will execute for 100 times. That's the use of loop. So we can control this loop using two statements. What is that? Continue statement and break statement. Let's take an example and understand what's continue statement do and what's break statement will do. So continue statement, if someone asked you to display the numbers from 10 to 1 but don't display the number 5, what we have to do? We have to skip that iteration. We should not display the number 5. We have to skip that. How to skip that? Using the continue statement. Using the continue statement, let's understand how we can write this code using a example. I is equal to 10. So what's our goal is? We have to display the numbers from 10 to 1. So I is equal to 10 while I greater than 0. Yes, 10 greater than 0. Condition satisfied means this complete block of code belongs to while loop. In that we are having if statement. So again indentation, this block of code belongs to if statement, this complete block of code belongs to while loop. So this is how we maintain the indentation. So if condition satisfies, again if 10 equal to 5, no, condition fails, so don't execute this block of code. This block of code belongs to if, so don't execute this. Only execute this block of code only when we are having condition is met. So condition is failed here, so execute the remaining code. Print I, what is the value we get? 10. I is equal to I minus 1 means 9. Again check the condition. If 9 greater than 0, yes. 9 equal to 5, no. So print the statement. 9, 8, 7, 6. Whenever I value is 5, 5 is equal to 5, yes, 5. So go inside and execute the loop, execute the condition statement. 5 minus 1, 4. I is equal to 4 value. So now it is executing the statement continue. What's this continue will do is it will skip the present iteration. It won't execute the remaining while loop statements in this iteration. In this iteration, it will go for the next iteration. So what's the remaining code we have here? Print I and I minus 1. It won't allow to execute this code. That is what the use of continue statement. Whenever it encounters the statement continue, it will stop executing that loop up to here. It won't allow to execute the remaining part of the code. Remaining part of the code for this iteration, only for this iteration. So now it won't display 5 because these two lines are not getting executed. So it will skip these two parts and again continue. Our next iteration means 4 greater than 0, yes, the condition is met. Again, if 4 is equal to 5, no, condition fail. So it won't go into this block of code. It will execute print I means 4, 3, 2, 1. After completion of this while loop, continue executing the remaining part of the code. That is how while loop will be executed. That is how we use the continue statement for discarding the one iteration. Whatever the iterations we want to discard, that we can discard by using the continue statement. So what's the difference between continue and break statement is, if you want to discard the entire loop, whenever the programming encounters the break statement, it will stop executing the complete loop. So that's why if you say it as break, it will continue executing from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Whenever it see the statement I is equal to 5, 5 is equal to 5, whenever it encountered the break statement, it will stop executing the loop. The entire loop will be discarded. It won't execute anymore. Only the loop will be discarded. The entire loop statement means it will, the output of this program is it will display 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Whenever it got a I value as 5, 5 is equal to 5. So it went into the if statement and it will execute this block of code. It will encounter the break statement. So this entire loop will be discarded. It won't continue to execute this loop. So this is the output, and it will come out of this loop and it will continue executing the remaining code. What's the output here? Thank you. So this is what the statements continue and break statements is. It's very, very important because we use most of the times these statements in our real time problems. Okay, coming to next one, in this while loop we are having the else statement also. So what we discussed in our previous classes, if condition satisfies, execute that if block of code, otherwise go to else statement. Like that same way, while loop is also having an else statement here. If you write it as I is equal to 1 while I less than or equal to 5, print I plus same code, but we have written an else part here. While else, printf else. So what's this mean is it will execute for 5 times. Whenever the condition fails, it goes into the else part. Means the output we get here for this program is I is equal to 1. It started from 1. It will display 1, print of I, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whenever I value is 6, it will fail. The condition fails. While condition will fail. Whenever the condition fails, it goes into the else part. Else means display else. After that, continue executing the remaining part of the code. What's the remaining part of the code? Thank you. Okay, this is what the meaning of else. Whenever the condition fails, go to else part. But the important point we have to remember here is this else statement will not be executed if we break in the middle. See here, if you write the else part for a the same program, we have written the else part here, but this program is breaking in the middle. It is not executing till all the conditions checks. It is not, the condition has not failed. Here we break in the middle. The loop execution is broken in the middle. In these situations, the else part will not be executed. So the output for this is 10, 9, 8, 7, 6 and thank you. It won't go to the else part. Whenever the condition fails, then only it will go into the else part. Remember that point, that's very important to understand. Okay, this is all about while loop and control statements for loops, continue and break statement. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.